Okay, so while I'm getting another deep video ready, I thought you and me would have fun with a quick one. So I want to show you how I configure my Git and what I think are the most important settings, so you should put them into your config right now. At first, let me show what files we will be working with. I'm a big fan of editing my configuration files manually as a text, so we will not be using Git config command, but edit the whole file here. Okay, so first file obviously is our user git configuration located in .config, git config in our home directory. This file contains settings that are specific to your user and they'll be used in all your repositories. The second file is a user git ignore file located in the same directory. Third one is my favorite, the commit template file in the same directory as well. And the last one is different for everyone. It's a user shell configuration. If you're using zshell, it will be zshrc. If you're using bash, it will be bashrc, etc. Yeah, and let's actually start with the shell configuration because this will make our life easier. So using Git requires sometimes a lot of typing. For example, when we need to check out current repository status, we need to type git status command. It's not that much, but if we do it a lot, it can be so annoying. So first we will create an alias for git status. So instead of full command, we could type a shortcut. And I prefer it very short, GS, just 2 letters. It makes it very easy to type. So when I get into directory, I can just type another 2 letters to check out what's going on in the repository. So let's add this alias to our shell configuration file. And actually, we could also add an option for the command. Status by default is showing info in not the most compact and readable way. But with short flag, we can make it better, in my opinion, so let's keep it an alias as well. So before we continue with configuration, let's add common alias first. For me, it is gd for gdiff to check out the changes, ga for git add to add them to staging area, GC for git commit to commit them, GP or git push to push them into a remote repo, GU or git pull to get the latest changes from it, GL or git log to check out latest commits, GB for git branch to check out branches, GCO for git checkout to switch between branches, and GI for git init to create a new repo, GCL or git clone to clone a new repo. Since every git command is now 2-3 letters, I can type them very fast and I can perform all the operations faster than in GUI. So now we can easily invoke our commands, but some of them are still not very easy to use. Let's fix this by configuring the git itself. Before configuring separate commands, let's set some general options. So in user section, I set name and email to identify my commits. In core section, I set compression to level 9 so I can trade some CPU to speed up network transfers and save some disk space. I also set white space to error so Git will warn me if I try to commit trillion spaces. Then I set preload index to a true so Git will load the index into memory, improving performance. Then in advice section, I like to disable all the advice messages. So add empty path spec, push none fast forward, and status hints. And now let's configure some commands. So the first thing we are going to do with our repos is cloning them. Currently, instead of classic git clone URL, we made it GCL URL. But this URL could be still a long string to type, and Git provide us some URL shortcuts too, so we can make it shorter. For example, I often clone my own repositories or forks. They are usually hosted on GitHub, and it started like github.com/codingjerks/. You can see it. Instead of typing this long string I could not even remember, I create a URL shortcut in Git configuration like this. So now instead of typing the whole long URL, I can just prefix repo name with CJ colon. Also, sometimes I need to clone a repo from GitHub. Often I don't remember the name and especially the full URL, so just copy it from the browser. But quite often I do remember it, so in that cases I have GH colon shortcut, helping me to clone the repo without remembering the long repetitive prefix. So Lastly, for working repositories, I have shortcut reader, since it's the name of my team. And again, instead of writing the full URL like this, I just write in reader, colon, repo name, and I'm good to go. Okay, next command is gi, git init. There is not much to configure here, but I prefer making my default branch named dev instead of master, since it's a bit easier to type and it's working well with my Git workflow. So let's add it to our config as well. Next, when I work with my repo, I need to check out the status often with gs, git status. We changed it a bit already, but to improve output even further, we have a few options in status section. So I set branch to true to show the current branch name in the output. I set show stash to true to show the stash info. And I set show untracked files to all to show all untracked files without grouping them into directories. This one is a bit controversial, but I like it this way. Usually, if I have untracked files, I either need to ignore them or I add them into a repo. In both cases, I find it easier to see them all in the output. Okay, so next command I'm using a lot, being in a repo after checking out status, is gd, git diff. First, in git, I don't like to see the plus and minus signs in the output. Instead, I like to use just colors to highlight the changes. To disable the signs, we can add output indicator new and output indicator old arguments to our alias. Then, in the git config, in diff section, I reduce the number of context lines so it's more compact. And I also like to set rename to copies, so Git will detect renames and copies to make the output cleaner. Then I also set interhang context to 10, so new hunks of code get grouped together, making it again easier to read. Then, to make the output even better, I use diff so fancy tool. So first install it, and after that, in section pager, set diff to diff so fancy. To configure it even further, in diff so fancy section, I set mark empty lines to false. So first empty lines of a block are not marked with color. And in section color diff, I set color so it's easier to read the output. And from default diff like this, I'm getting this. Okay, so after I know what's going on in my repo and I change some files, I actually want to add them using ga or git add. But usually I use another command that allows me to confirm the changes before adding them into the staging area, one by one, so change by change. It's git add patch or gap, alias I make it shorter. Running this command in the repo with changes will show me every hunk of code with added or removed lines, and I can choose if I want to stage it with Y or not with N. Sometimes if chunk contains too many lines, I can split it with S, or I can edit it manually with E. So to make this command even better, I enable diff so fancy for it as well. So in interactive section, I set diff filter to diff so fancy patch. And then I like to set single key to true. So when I need to confirm the changes, I don't need to press enter after I choose like Y or N. And after I stage all the changes I want, I usually want to confirm them, like to check if I staged everything I wanted and I didn't stage something by mistake. So for this, I use git diff staged, or for me, GDS. Okay, now we have our changes staged, and we can commit them with git commit or gc. Sometimes I prefer writing commit messages right here, so command will become this. But sometimes I prefer writing in a real code editor, Nelim in my case. This way I just run gc and get into the editor. It's already quite easy to write good commit messages here, but to make it even easier, I set two options. First is the verbose option, with which git will include more context into the file where we write commit messages. This way we can get more from buffer autocompletion or stuff like copilot. And another option is template, where I'm setting own template file using for every new commit message. And in this template file, I list example for common prefixes for commit messages I usually use. So it's like this. This way, after I run gc, I can uncommit needed prefix, add my commit message, and I'm good to go. All this simplifies process of creating new commits and allows me to make commits more often. Okay, now to push the changes to remote repo, we can use git push or gp to configure it. In push section, I set few options. Auto setup remote to true, so git will automatically set remote tracking branches, and I don't need to specify them manually. Then default to current, so git will push only current branch if I don't specify anything else. Follow text to true, so git will also push tags every time because I usually use them to create releases. To pull the changes from the remote, I use git pull or gu, u from update. Okay, so in pull section of config, I set default to current again to pull only current branch if I don't specify anything else. Rebase to true, so if there are any local changes, I like to them being rebased instead of git creating a merge commit. And here I like to configure rebase also, and in rebase section I have auto stage to true, so if I have any unstaged local changes, they are getting automatically staged and applied after. And missing commits check to warn. This option is actually for manual rebases, just to warn me if I accidentally remove some commits while editing. Okay, and now let's make our git log better. By default, git log or GL show us a lot of information in not so readable way, in my opinion. There is one line option which makes it more dense, but I prefer it another way. First of all, in GL alias, I add all flag so I can see all the git refs. Then I add graph to make it easier to track branches and merges in graph-like view. Then I like to put all the necessary information for me in two lines, setting the option pretty format to this one. And here %h is the commit hash, %an is the author name, %ar is the time pass signs commit, and %d is the ref names. When I have my second line, and on it I have %s commit message. And finally, additional new line adding the merging between commits. So in the result, instead of this, I get this. Oh, and I did change a bit more here. In the config in log section, set a brief commit to true to shorten the commit hashes, and update the graph colors to improve color ordering. And in the color decorate section, I am also setting necessary ref colors so it's easier to identify them for me. Okay, and we are almost done here. Let's also make our git branch and git tag commands better. For them, I'm already pretty happy with the output, except the colors and sorting. To configure the colors, I set color branch section to this. And for sorting, in the branch section, I set them to minus committer date, and to sort text to minus tagger date, so more recent refs are shown first. Also, I like to disable default pager for these commands. I will call it myself when I need it. So in pager section, I set branch and tag to false. Okay, and last thing, I like to have a nice green badge near my commits, so I set up commit signing with GPG case. So last thing is, in user section, I set my signing key. And finally, in commit section, I set GPG sign to true, so my every commit will be signed. Okay, and that's all for today. So you can check out full config in my .files repository. Link is on the screen and in the description. Subscribe to get more videos like this, and I will see you in the next one.